What is going on, everybody? I go by the name of Kari, and I want to thank you guys for joining me here today on Sneaker Fetish. You know, it's getting kind of crazy when I get a sneaker in. If it's after the release date of the sneaker, I actually find myself racking my brain about exactly what I want to say, just because on YouTube these days, it feels like if you're not early, you're late. But today I have a really special sneaker, and even though it's already come out, I wanted to talk about the fact that not a lot of people really bought these. It seems like they're sitting on a lot more websites than I would have thought they did. And while they're great, there's some things about the drop and some things about the sneaker that I wish Jordan Brand maybe could have done a little bit better. Also, I have a special shout out at the end of the video that has to do with this sneaker, so make sure you stick around for that. But without further ado, let's get into the shoe. Boom. And there it is, ladies and gentlemen. This is the Air Jordan 7 Flint for 2021. This is one of those sneakers where if you know, you know. We're not gonna spend a lot of time talking about this shoe, but I do wanna get a little bit into the sneaker if you've never seen it before. Take a look at the materials, the quality, things like that. Then I also wanna talk a little bit about the history of this shoe, because to me, this is one of the more special sneakers that kind of flies under the radar. You don't hear a lot of people talking about, but for a lot of OGs in the sneaker game, this one is really special. Let's get into it. All right, guys, starting with the upper of the sneaker here. Now, you guys notice it's mainly a white upper on the Air Jordan 7 silhouette. Of course, the Air Jordan 7 silhouette, very popular silhouette, but it seems to only be most popular in certain colorways. The Bordeaux, maybe the Cardinals, the Olympic 7s. Everybody kind of has their favorite Jordan 7, and while they don't collect every colorway like the Air Jordan 1, that special colorway people tend to love. But for the Flints, this is basically a reiteration of the 2006 version, where you have that plain white upper with that really nice tumbled leather, and the leather is not bad on these. The leather is pretty good. Now, of course, that white tumbled leather is offset by that Flint gray nubuck that's in all of the panels and in the toe box of the sneaker. Of course, up in the column, also laid on top of that Flint gray nubuck, is that dark Concord stitched in Jumpman. Very nice touch. Also, true to its predecessor, you have kind of that stacked little, I don't know, you can call it a mountain. Different people call it different things, but the accents on the midsole starts with the white, goes with the black, and then of course goes into the Flint gray outsole. Taking the top down, look at the shoe here. No extra laces. You get the plain white laces. I'm interested to see you guys lace swaps. I've already seen some very dope ones. You get a really nice view of that really nice nubuck toe box, and then of course you get the neoprene classic Air Jordan 7 tongue with the dark Concord Air Jordan stitched in. Small detail that I can appreciate Jordan Brand bringing back, just like the 2006 pair, on the 2021 pair, you also are going to get those silver metal lace tips once again on the laces. Really nice. Moving around to the back of the shoe, again, just like the 2006 pair, you have that classic Air Jordan 7 heel tab with that dark Concord 23. Fun fact, if you guys see in the gray here, you guys notice that that's the number 7. I don't know if you guys ever noticed that, but actually the number 7 for Jordan 7 is kind of outlined right here in the gray. Of course, on the right shoe, like I'm showing you, usually it's inverted, but if you look on the left shoe, you can see that 7 a lot more pronounced. On the outsole of the shoe, classic Air Jordan 7 outsole, little dark Concord Jumpman on the heel of the shoe, some other little dark Concord hits on the forefront, and on the insole of the shoe here, black insole with that white Jumpman on the heel. Fun fact, the back of this insole says AJ8, so I guess this is the Air Jordan 8 insole on the Air Jordan 7. And that's pretty much it when it comes to the 2021 Air Jordan 7 Flint. Now, I'm gonna really show my age probably in this video. I'm gonna sound like one of those back in my day kind of guys, but back in my day, I don't know, man, sneakers were a lot more fun than they are today. And what I mean by that is, this sneaker takes me back to a more carefree time that wasn't built on hype and apps and resale value. Back in the day where these originally dropped, people more than likely were buying sneakers to wear them, not to sell them. And so it was a little bit different, especially in terms of accessibility of the shoe. Now, back in 2006, we were starting to get the idea of consolation pairs of sneakers. And what I mean by that was, if you guys remember, the exact same day that the Flint 7 dropped, the Cardinal 7 dropped. And the Cardinal, by and large, I would say, is probably a little bit more popular of a colorway. This Flint 7 was the lifestyle version of the Jordan Jordan 7 that dropped on the same day, April 22nd, 2006, if memory serves me correctly. The Cardinal was the OG. It was the one that Michael Jordan wore on his foot. It was the one that people really wanted to rock. But of course, lifestyle versions of different sneakers were starting to become popular. We saw lifestyle Air Jordan 5s that were really hot, some colorways more than others. And this was about 2 months before we actually saw the Citrus 7 drop, which was a very, very popular colorway even to this day. But the Flint 7 was really that sneaker where you either really, really liked it or you could kind of pass up on it. Now, the 2006 version, a lot of people have been really complaining a little bit, like, it doesn't look exactly like it. The Flint gray, I will admit, is a lot darker than the original Flint gray was. That Flint gray definitely was a lot lighter. And maybe that's part of the reason why a lot of people didn't really pick these up. Because what I found is that now we're a few days after this sneaker has released, and I haven't really seen that many people talking about it, rocking it, or really excited about it. And not only that, but if you look enough places right now, you can definitely find them for retail price. I dare say that we may end up seeing a couple of pairs of these sneakers on sale, which is kind of crazy in the Jordan retro days. And I actually asked my Twitter feed that. If you guys aren't following me on Twitter and Instagram, make sure you do that. Shameless plug at SneakerPhetish. But I asked some of the people on Twitter, why didn't this sneaker sell? What happened? And different people had different answers. Some of you guys said that they just aren't a fan of the Air Jordan 7. They just don't like the silhouette. They don't like the way it looks. I respect it. Other people said that they just really didn't like the fact that the gray was a different color. I respect it. But at the end of the day, what a lot of people were also saying was that the sneaker just wasn't hyped up enough. Because I raised the question, even though a lot of people don't like the Air Jordan 7, does that mean that all 7s are trash, or does it mean that this one just wasn't hyped up enough? If a Travis Scott 7 came out, would you buy that? If an Off-White 7 dropped, would you buy that? If a Fragment 7 dropped, would you buy that? And if the answer is probably yeah, you don't have to admit that. It's okay. It's just between us. You don't have to admit that. But if you would buy it, then it's possible that these just weren't hyped up enough to get people to buy into it. This was a nod to the OGs. This was a nod to 2006. And it's been 15 years since we got a Flint Air Jordan 7. That's a long time to wait for a sneaker. So for some people, this was like a big deal. For a lot of people that had this sneaker back in 06, or if you were like myself, couldn't afford this sneaker back in 06 and like just looking at it, now we finally have our chance to get our hands on a piece of history here. But if you weren't around in 06, if you weren't really that old 15 years ago, because again, if you're 18 years old watching this video, you were 3 years old when this sneaker dropped, and chances are you didn't really know much about what was going on back then. So I appreciate Jordan Brand really trying to make sure that they cater to the OGs. Honestly, I don't know if we'll ever see the Flint 7s again, especially with the response that this sneaker got with not that many people rocking with it. So enjoy it. And listen, if this was a sneaker you were trying to get your hands on, chances are you definitely could get your hands on these no problem. So congratulations on getting this sneaker into your collection. Last but not least, if you guys noticed this t-shirt that I'm wearing here, it's an Uncivilized t-shirt. I wear Uncivilized a lot because that's my guy, Mr. Fomer Simpson's brand. And of course, if you subscribe to me, there's a very good chance that you're also subscribed to Fomer. But one funny thing about this sneaker is that 11 months ago, Fomer put out a video about this sneaker here, the 2006 version of the Flint 7s, and he talked about how much he loved the sneaker, but he didn't have enough money to get them. His brother tried to get them, but wasn't able to grab them, and how this sneaker actually got a 10 out of 10 for him because of how special the shoe was. What's funny is that in the video, he mentioned he didn't know if this sneaker was ever going to retro again, but it looks like you spoke that one into existence, my man, because here they are. Somebody at Jordan Brand must have been listening to you, so congratulations. But that's pretty much all that I got for these. Now it's time for you guys to sound off down below in the comments. Let me know what you guys think about the 2021 Air Jordan 7 Flint. Were these ones that you guys had on your radar to cop? Were you back there in 06 trying to get yourself a pair, or did you want to double up and get yourself a new pair of these? Or were these a hard pass for you? Either way, sound off down below. Let me know. Of course, right down in the comments, make sure that you click on that subscribe button so we can welcome you into the Sneaker Fetish family, and make sure you don't miss out on any more heat that comes through like these, because I guarantee you, I got a lot more heat on the way. As always, I want to thank you guys for joining me here today on Sneaker Fetish, taking a look at these with me, unboxing them with me for a couple of minutes. I go by the name of Kari. This is the 2021 Air Jordan 7 Flint, and until next time, I'm out.